Hi guys, essentially I respect my character to the atomic powers. So let's see what it does. It doesn't tell us all that much with the dummies. So here's what we'll do instead. Oh, let's try maybe the. Can I switch to tank? Okay, for the tank, I went mostly with tank-related powers that would give immunities or things like that. Or tank buff, as you can see under my character's name. But I guess it's just while we do missions that we'll really see what's going on. So let's go do a few missions. So let's go to Metropolis. And one of the reasons why I pretty much never use respect tokens is that I find it confusing, I suppose, when you. When you start with a whole bunch of powers that you have no idea what they're doing, as opposed to discovering your powers gradually. So usually I much prefer to use a brand new character. But I'll make an exception with this one. Essentially with this character, I already had an armory and also I have the base, the new 52 base item, the multiverse base item, the orrery. I'm sorry, no idea how to pronounce that properly. So let's get out of here. Oh yeah, we won the Ring War. I say we loosely, obviously I wasn't there. So let's see, we need two containment. So let's see what that does. Oh yeah, log box. So short term, I'll just worry about trying not to die and trying to see what the powers do. I'm gonna have to look up how the actual mechanic works because I have no idea how it does. I know that there's some combos, so let's try and maybe check one or two combos. Oh, and we got some new pants. Nah. And let's see what's in the box. Oh, let's go with the House of El war suit. Yeah. I will keep that for another character, though. Well, let's try a combo or two. So let's see. So if I tap range, I'll do neutron explosion. So let's try that. Okay, it does that only once or twice. That's kind of neat. You do actually more than you have to tap it more than once, and there's like two combos. Oh, that's kind of neat. So let's see the other one. Oops. For this one, tap range also. Is that all tap range? No combo here, no combo here. This one is tap melee. This one doesn't seem to have a combo. Okay, so let's try that. Let's try here, that tap range. Okay, so we can tap range more than once to do them combos, and it's holy crap, that's really cool. Okay, and this one, holy crap.
Tech leveled not just the star transports carrying Grodd's tech, but others as
Grodd
well.
Said you would be coming.
Pillage the remains of the
transport revolver technology.
That device has hacked out the last of Grodd's technology from Gorilla Island. Ever since Ultra Humanite tried to take over the island, Grodd's had a new device.
Gorilla Technician Report. General.
What are you going to do to me?
I forgot to take super strength. Next time. So as you see right off the bat, even if you don't really know how to use the powers properly, just using the combo, that's really cool. So let's start by taking the side mission, but I guess not.
Self-destruct.
I have to be careful. There's a Hawkman and Hawkwoman here sometimes. I guess I'm done with the generators.
Other dimensions do exist. Magic, meta, technological.
There's Hawkman and Aquaman, but I won't I won't attack them yet. They'll be just not out of me, so maybe later, much later, like in 30 combat rating or so. So let's see if those shoulders are good. Not really. So what else can we do? I guess we're going to go inside, inside Star Lab. Oh yeah, that's the monkey mission. It's a fun mission, as long as you don't mind having banana breath. That's been a while. I hope I remember the combos. Well, the... These generators are one of the side missions, so if you ever do this mission and somehow you don't have the generators to destroy, it's that either you already did the side mission or you didn't take the side mission yet. As you can see, there's various abilities that you have as a monkey. Some are better than others, I suppose. I'll try and show you them to you one by one. So the first one is this one where you actually jump towards your target, which is a pretty good one. Then there's the second one, which is, as you saw, you take like some sort of swing and then you end up hitting your target with your feet. It usually ends up hitting pretty much anyone in front of you. This one, that's okay. So the third one is like a big hit on the floor. But it was the second one. Let's try it again. No, I can't yet. There we go. The last one, as you can see, you jump up and down. The fifth one seems to be some sort of a yield. Oh, there you go. You pump your chest and although it doesn't help you much when you get this not beaten out of you, but I think there's too many people here now. Not sure if I pulled too many people or just too many people spawned. Either could be true. I probably pulled too many people when I jumped. I guess when you jump, it kind of pulls everyone around you. Stand by for the next stage of your evolution. Let's try that again. Enjoy your higher state of being. I think you can, you can climb walls. I guess it turns you kind of into an acrobat, sort of. So let's try that again. Okay, let's look at the fourth ability. What does it do? That's it. Fall back. We need a bigger gun. Guess you're sharing your banana breath with everyone. Well, I'm not sure why. Well, there seems to be a bit of a glitch in the interface, but nah, that's not a big deal. This isn't one of Grodd's usual monkeys. And I guess this is it for the monkey boy. Oh yeah, we're going to fight both flashes today. Maybe I should have done this mission yesterday. During Flash Day. But it's okay. So in this mission here, essentially you transform one of the Flashes as a monkey, And you send the barrel at the other end of the earth, of course. So while one flash is turned into a monkey, you fight the other one, and vice versa. Oh. As you can see, once I activate this again, it'll turn Barry Allen as a monkey, and then you fight Jay Garrick. Let's switch again. So once we defeat one of the flashes, then you have to defeat the other one. Oh, he destroyed the machine. And there we go. So let's talk to our friend Grodd. If we're real lucky, we'll get the flash boots, but I didn't expect us to be lucky. Although I'm not sure if you can get the boots from this version of the mission or if you have to do the, I think it's a tier 1 mission? Tier 1 or tier 2? And I think that is pretty much it for us. Let's just look around quickly. Yep. Oh yeah. We got a new PowerPoint, so let's see what we can purchase with that. Maybe. Well, let's go with that. This is the one I wanted to use. Let's take that. And let's replace. Well, let's replace this one. Let's try it out. Oh. Is there a combo? I guess not. Okay, so this has a molecular pressure. This and this. So let's try that. This should be 1, this should be 2, this should be 3, and let's try that. Maybe I'll notice more of a difference when I try it in battle. We'll see. So let's go back to Midtown.
that Grodd has regained his broadcast technology. Soon, all of Metropolis will serve his whim. We will be sure to devolve you first, as a reward for your service.
Ever heard of Eclipso? His black diamond can turn even the sweetest soul to evil. And now Cersei wants to set him free. Felix Faust in the safe house has more.
Welcome to Exploration Adventures with Booster Gold. I'm Booster Gold. This adventure will take you to Centennial Park, a peaceful oasis hidden amidst the bustling...
The heart of darkness is a legendary black diamond. Untroubled evil. Now manifesting in shards across Metropolis. Collect... I'll reward you against... The diamond's corrosive touch.
Oh crap, I forgot one of the generators. I'll get it next time. But I think I'll go to my base first. Let's reimprint our character. Could have sworn we got something else. Oh well. So let's put our little helmet here. And let's go to the mall. No idea what the closest there it is. I was looking too far. There should be a side mission. Ah, there it is. So let's try that. One. There was no one around.
Thank you.
Obviously, I'm doing something wrong since the nuclear blast doesn't seem to do that much damage. We'll see. Let's see what the supercharge does. There we go.
Careful with those black diamonds. I know Faust gave you a ward, but those things
and a new weapon. Let's stick with our brawling weapon. seem to hear something. Oh, there it is. The sneaky devs. Blue on blue. The side quest is right here. Let's switch and see how the other powers work. So that seems to be a defense buff. One, I'm not sure. Let's try it again. Oh, that's another defense buff. Okay. As you could see, the favorite sport in this universe online, teabagging. And I guess he's going to stick around and try it again. The sad thing is I did a raid with this guy just earlier today. Okay, let's see what else we can do. That's the same thing. I guess we could do a few of the explorers. Teabagger is sticking with us. So let's take the opportunity to sell and repair, and we'll go back out there after. Let's try again, and if somehow there's still high-level players in the area, we'll just go do some exploring.
magical energy.
Oh yeah. So let's see, I think the next one is Nightfall. Oh, well, went a little too far. in the wrong direction, I suppose. I think we're going to keep the glass we're wearing right now. So that will be it for today with our atomic character. So far, the powers are really fun to use. Lots of combos to remember, I suppose, and lots of new mechanics to try to figure out. But it should be fun overall. The visuals are really great. They look really nice. So I guess I'm going to try to figure out a bit more how the powers actually work. But so far, it's a fun power to use. So that's it for now. So hopefully I'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.